When I moved out here to build my little log cabin, I knew I wanted to be closer to nature, be in touch with nature, and enjoy nature more. I like to plant flowers that attract butterflies and bees and like help them, you know, thrive. I want them to thrive in my yard. You get like a little ecosystem going with them. So you help and give to them, and then they help you by pollinating all your vegetable garden, you know, your vegetables in your vegetable garden. And of course, all your fruit bushes, your fruit trees or whatever. So it's like a mutually beneficial relationship that you have. So it's really, really fun to develop that. And also, it's just very beautiful. It just beautifies your homestead when you walk out. It just like puts a smile on your face because it just looks so good when you pull up in the car or just when you're out doing stuff. I wanted to raise my own food, get closer to nature, enjoy the solitude and the beauty. But also, I have this creative streak in me. So I love to strategically place my plants and bushes and stuff so it's visually very appealing. It's like double duty. It helps the bees and butterflies, but it's also very visually pleasing when you walk out and you spend time outside. This little line here just gives a little extra privacy between the barn and the cabin when I'm walking back and forth from anybody that's out in the road or in the yard there. And so I like to plant the flowers to do that, which I just love that. And also just to make it a little cute, just a little prettier, you can like make a little archway that you walk through. And all the bees love all these plants and flowers. So you're helping nature, but you're also making things pretty and practical at the same time. So when you plant flowers or bushes or trees or whatever, like think about it and then strategically place them so they're functional and beautiful. I have my chicken coop, which of course is very functional, and I love my chickens so much. And then I like flowers too. And what I did is I planted the flowers in front of the chicken coop just to beautify the chicken pens a little bit. And so what I like to do is plant something very colorful, just so it's visually pleasing. And then the chickens and also Neil, they appreciate that little bit of extra shade and they kind of hide under there when they're like leaning over in bloom. Down here I have my milkweed and the monarch butterflies come and lay their eggs on this. This is the only plant that the monarch butterfly lays their eggs on. So of course, I just love to help out the monarch butterfly population. And right here, I have a beautiful gardenia bush. And the nice thing about gardenias is when they're in bloom, they smell just so luscious. And there's just a little teeny one here in bloom, but even this little teeny weeny little flower has so much fragrance. So that's very enjoyable when you're out here to feed the chickens and take care of Neil. You can just enjoy the beautiful smell of the flowers. So it's like just a very dual purpose if you plant a beautiful little garden in front of your animal pens. So after I attract all the bees and butterflies, they need a little place to lay their eggs and to call home. This little bee house I made a couple years ago, and this is for native bees, not honeybees. But there's hundreds of different varieties. And sometimes they're called mason bees. And the reason for that is there's little holes and it gets a piece of pollen and then it puts an egg in the piece of pollen and it crawls back way in the hole and then it puts that in there and then it builds a little wall. And then it just repeats that process all the way to the end of the hole. So in each hole, there's like lots of little chambers of a pollen ball and an egg. And as you can see, there's different colors. So that's different types of mason bees. And of course, the babies have to get the stuff out of the end when they all hatch, and then it just starts all over again, and then the bees will fill that up. So if you have a lot of flowers and stuff to attract the bees in your vegetable garden, of course, then you can also build a little bee house, or you can have several little bee houses around your homestead. You can see the video on how I made this, and the link is down below in the description. So make sure that you plant in a strategic, practical way that benefits you and your animals, and also you're helping nature. And on top of that, you get to enjoy the beauty every day. Thanks for watching. YouTube has this new feature where you can sponsor creators if you want to, and the button for that is down below. Please click the like button and subscribe. Also, I love to hear your comments and questions down below. You can write those to me. I'll answer you the best I can. And we'll see you next time. Happy homesteading. Bye-bye.